that the fans are going to be the winners every single time when they watch the news. That's what it means.
David, how do you attribute that? Are you accurate? Is it the power?
It's a gift of God. You know, I take advantage of it. It's not. It's something I've had since I was as a kid. And now all there is to do is to perform it and to know how to use it and to work with it and not work at it as a plan. And which I had, which I've made the mistake once in the past, but this is no longer a mistake. So. I believe I'm the hardest puncher in the world at 160. So we'll see. We'll just have to see in the long run.
Dave, would you ever want to have a rematch with Lemieux? I mean, he's still a good fighter, even though he's coming off the loss to Triple G.
Yeah.
But I mean, is that something you've thought about, just to clean that up a little bit, even if there's no need to? But he's still a reputable name.
I've had dreams about it for ages, but you know. All is relevant to where it's going to lead me, and right now it's in the past. And that's, if Rubio was ranked, then it would have been a good fight. The fans would have wanted to see, and it would have been comfortable for everybody. For sure, I would love to fight Rubio anytime. Of course, he's a good fighter, but I don't know now if it's worth it. So, but if it was tomorrow, I would love to.
David, you've been boxing since you were 9. Can you describe that moment when you decided that you wanted to become a boxer?
Wow, I never really thought of that, you know, but since the reason I started so young is because I used to be, you know, a little troublemaker. I used to fight a lot in the streets. I would get kicked out of school, so I was smoking cigars. all types of, and my neighbor was a boxer, so, you know, seeing me come home with the police, getting kicked out of school, said, you know, if you like fighting so much, come fight with some real fighters, people who can fight. And that's how I fell in love with it. I came in the gym, the first guy I saw I wanted to fight against, I got my ass kicked, I don't know, 2,500 times, but I kept coming, I fell in love with it, and it saved my life, and it made me the man I am today.
I know you're comfortable at middleweight, but do you see yourself eventually going up to 168?
No.
Should be like Marvin Hagler, stay 160?
160, for sure I'm still only 26. Later on, for sure I'm probably going to go up to 168. But for now, we're comfortable at 160. And we want to make a good job at 160, then turn the page and move up.
David, you mentioned that you started boxing at 9 years old and your development as a fighter. Is there someone that you look to try to mimic at all in those development stages when you're kind of just finding yourself as a fighter?
To tell you the truth, you know, I'm not gonna lie or anything, but I've never really been like a big fan of boxing. Like I never like watched like specific fighters. You know, I like old school fighters. You know, I watch Oscar, I watch Bernard, I watch Sugar Ray Robinson, Sugar Ray Leonard, you know, Ali and all them guys, and you know, with Tyson, you know, I always like power punchers and strong fighters. So, but I've never like mimicked anybody or something like that. I have my own style, and I respect other fighters with their style, but I've never like wanted to be like somebody else. I am who I am, and I like who I am. So, and I respect others, the great champions, and that's it.
On a follow-up to that, you mentioned that you were never really big in watching fights. What sports were you into then? What were you always watching?
I was never really like, I'm more like a doer. I always like to play sports. I would always be out with friends, playing football or stuff like that. But watching sports, I never sat home and watched sports and stuff like that. I was never like, hey guys, let's go watch a football game or something like that, you know. I'm not
a troublemaker, man. He told you.
Troublemaker, exactly. I was beating up those guys. Yeah.
Oscar, he's the only Canadian who doesn't watch hockey. Yeah.
This week, Bihab turned 50. He's making history. I don't think anybody will ever fight at 50. What do you think about Bihab's
title? Every single person on the face of this earth has to respect him. I don't think we have a choice anymore because of what he's accomplished. Who he is, 50 years old, to still be competing at the highest level.
That's one example in all sports history.
Yep.
Gordie Howe, the hockey player, he was 52.
See, we're not just talking about boxing. We're talking about every sport across the board. There's nobody, and there never will be again, a Bernard Hopkins. Whether it's baseball, hockey, soccer, there will never, ever be an athlete like Bernard Hopkins.
And I want to say one thing. Lemieux, he's in middleweight. And sitting here at this press conference, and I'm always thinking about history, and I'm always thinking about the future of boxing, but mainly a division that made me, Dan, the middleweight division. And to sit here as I'm hearing questions and I'm hearing him respond, and how your upbringing was, I'm like, yo, you sure you lived in Philly and then moved to Canada? But we'll talk about that later, right? It might be a secret. But, and I'm sitting here, Oscar, and everybody's here, and I'm saying to myself, middleweight division, amongst the names y'all mentioned, possible matches and all this stuff, it's got my blood boiling, like, yo, like, and then it's like, damn, it wasn't like that. When I was coming up, we had one or two guys, but he has a lot of guys in that middleweight division, other than Triple G, that's under him or whatever, matches that could be made. But having the middleweight division is part of my legacy, right? And seeing now the molding of another legacy, right? It's been at this press conference, it's had the chance to mold himself into that, his legacy, and as he said, his style. And I like that about him. I like that about him saying, look, I respect all the fighters that came past and present, to my left, to my right, to my right, to my left. But at the end of the day, he has an opportunity, because the middleweight division has always been the middle of all divisions. That's why it's middleweights, right? And it's always been a division of excitement, right? I've raised the bar so high. It ain't even about age. It's about the bar that I raised for himself and others that come behind him. And even when he leaves the game, the bar has been raised so high. I'm glad I contribute that to the middleweight division that's so long deep in history. From the Ray Robinsons, as y'all mentioned, the Ray Leonards, the Tommy Hearns, who was welterweight, eventually stopped past like middleweight, excuse me.
Marvin Hagler.
And Marvin Hagler. So Lemieux, you have the time in front of you more than back by age and time. Learn all you can, buddy. Learn how to do everything you possibly can in that ring, so you never would be surprised what another opponent would do. And that makes the complete fighter with longevity, right? And achievements. But I'm glad to be here at this press conference with a middleweight that everybody here, even the writers, I believe respect the way he fights, and the way what he brings to the table. And that's why this thing, as I sat here and listened to questions and said, man, the middleweight division is really alive. Never been completely dead like the heavyweight division, right? Until it starts tonight. But he has a great opportunity to build his legacy from here. And that's what I'm excited about, other than the signing of the move. Thank you for being with us and giving us a chance to prove ourselves.
Thank you, guys.
Happy to be here.
Bernard, you hold the record, obviously, for middleweight title defenses. Would you like to see a guy like David someday break that record?
No!
Short and sweet, no.
He's not from Philly.
But we're going to have fun watching you do it. And you know what? What better person to do it? And he's with us. And he's doing it. I mean, that's down the road, but that would be a great, 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 great something to talk about amongst media and amongst us. But what better person to break it is himself? And I get to sit here and help promote it and watch it. I got the best of both worlds.
Time is on my side.
Time is on your side, not mine.
Thank you very much, media. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you, guys.